but that doesn't mean it won't happen. Team Secret loves their hard to execute support duos.
Yeah, Virtus Pro actually are kind of maybe worried about the global strat because they had the Asian operation and Nature's Prophet removed, as already Secret has the Zeus.
Yeah,
talking about global, I actually, a hero that I've been missing slightly, I feel like it could be good, but I want to hear your opinion about Spectre.
I think Spectre's very good. I think she had a lot of items buffed that benefit her. If I actually need to go down the list of, like, it seemed like all of the item buffs that, like, so many things about her got better. But I think it's more of the play style of this patch doesn't really suit her as well. She can really get shut down in lane by a lot of heavy pressure, and there's a lot of good heavy pressure supports right now, and I think she just kind of struggles there. But if you can secure her lanes with really good defensive supports, I think a Spectre pick can definitely still work. Eternal Envy, one of the better Spectre players in the world. He loves being able to buy back Haunt. Any hero that does well out of buyback is something that Eternal Envy enjoys to play. So,
the pick of the Earth Spirit, though. Who's the Earth Spirit pick player? Who is the dirty one?
That is... I doubt it's Pylai Dai. It's probably Puppy. I would say Puppy's probably the Earth Spirit player.
I would actually have Pylai Dai.
I'm not sure. Puppy usually plays the more...
He plays the more four.
Yes.
Pylai Dai is more like the sacrificial lamb.
Exactly. That, just because of the... If Vengeance of being the core, maybe. But we'll see. For Virtus Pro, though, I'm going to be... I still think you have to worry about the Visage from them. Getting a small buff. The stone, I think it was the AoE of the Remnant stun. It's very small buff, but it was a buff.
And Lil's already a beast even when it wasn't buffed.
Yeah, Lil is a god at that hero anyway, so I think you always have to be scared of it. I think he works relatively well in this meta as well. He can split push and farm pretty well. So he's got that additional camp to farm on the side lane that I think works pretty well for him. Faceless Void picked up by Virtus Pro. I think that's a very good pickup against these very low cooldown heroes like Zeus.
Yeah, and heroes that you can potentially already kill inside a Chronosphere.
Exactly.
I mean, you already have the Vengeful Spirit against it, though.
The Vengeful Spirit works as a good way to swap out of Chrono. But we've seen, I think Winter, it was very, very into the Faceless Void picks. We saw a lot of it in China. We would see a lot of Faceless Voids go off lane. They pick up in Iron Talon a lot of the times. And you can just always fall back to that side lane, the side camp, and just Iron Talon the big creep. And you have such good stats that you can generally... Faceless Void is insane base damage, too.
Yeah.
So it's just something like a poor man shield. You can clear creeps out pretty well with Iron Talon.
The thing is, in Southeast Asia, you saw a lot of Faceless Void picked in the start of the qualifiers, but towards the end, nobody wanted it anymore because it lost so many games because you have to get that combination with the Chronosphere, whichever hero you pick with it, to get it right. Because in this patch, Faceless Void transitions more into an offlane, as you mentioned, into more of a utility hero with this Chronosphere.
Death Prophet is also another hero that you don't really mind if you have a not perfect Chrono. If you accidentally catch your Death Prophet in the Chrono, but she already has Exorcism going, it's not that bad. It's not like catching your like melee core in a Chrono. So it's a better situation. It makes it easier to execute.
I really like the Nyx Assassin.
Yeah, the Versus Zeus, it's really strong.
And there is still a possibility that it could be a Faceless Void safe lane, Nyx Assassin off lane? What do you reckon?
It could be.
Because DK Phobos Nyx is
DK
nice.
Phobos is one of the players that still believes in the off lane Nyx Assassin. So.
I believe in the offlane Nyx Assassin. I actually also believe in the mid Nyx Assassin. I saw that during the qualifiers, which is really fun to watch.
Yeah, I doubt they'll be putting Death Prophet like safe lane, but it's
Look at that!
The last
ban Terra Blade.
That's when I thought they would ban it.
I think that's smart.
Because I don't think they've telegraphed it too hard, but I think their draft does let it happen, and Virtus Pro has some issues with fighting at like 10 to 12 minutes, I think, before Faceless Void really has any damage to back up the Chrono.
Well,
and the Naga Siren.
If you can't have one illusion hero, you go for the other illusion hero.
Okay, well, is this how Team Secret thinks you play this patch? Is it?
Hey, it could still be support Naga and core Venge.
It could be. Pylai Dai does play support Naga Siren. So does Puppy, actually. Puppy played a lot of support Naga Siren, I think.
They used to.
I can't remember how often or how far back that was, but I do believe it happened up here.
I like that they keep it open, though. That is a strong point in a draft, I always find.
I do as well. I really like Zeus mid. I think Zeus with the Aetherlands buff is, or just the fact that it exists, was a very big buff to Zeus. It just, the cast range on your Chain Lightning and Bolt is so long now. everything about the build-up benefits him. He helps his survivability with the HP regen. It gives him a bigger mana pool, which he loves. It's just a very great item, Zeus.
Last pick prediction for Virtus Pro? Also, they keep it open, I mean, in terms of what they're going to do with their draft.
I still wouldn't be surprised to see a Visage here if it's a one Faceless Void and offlane Nyx Assassin. I think it's more likely this is off. Actually, I don't know if Virtus Pro believes in the offlane Nyx, offlane Faceless Void. It's been more of a Chinese thing. And it looks like it'll be a Lina. I think this is a mid Lina, support Nyx Assassin, Faceless Void safe lane. Actually, it can't be a mid. It's not a mid Lina because it's a Death Prophet.
And Lil picked up the Lina.
I'm being stupid. Yes, and Lil picked up the Lina, so it's a support Lina. I don't know how I feel about that support duo, though. Support Lina is something we haven't seen that
often. If you can get aggressive with her early on, and if you can get a lot of... If you can like, make a lot happen, I mean, it's really good. And he'll get a lot of farm. You know Lil will get farm.
It's Lil, right? Yeah. If someone is going to pick a support Lina and do well with it, and execute... Because it needs to be.
Which draft do you ever?
I like secrets. Yeah. I really do.
What needs to happen for their lineup to actually work? You feel like what do you look out for?
This that's the thing I think about secrets drafts. It doesn't require a whole lot. They just need to keep their Naga Siren alive, and they have a couple of very good heroes to do that. Mm-hmm. And as long as they can survive the early pressure from VP, I think they can be fine.
Okay, we're gonna find out if they can do exactly that because it is time for Virtus Pro versus Secret. You waited a while for it, but here it is. Time for our next game.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. We are live here in Minsk. Finally, we have a game three. My god, that did take over in a day, but exciting draft. They go for the Naga. I do
exciting draft, LD. That's the word. That's your word of choice.
The draft was exciting.
Okay.
The draft may be more exciting than the game, but they get the Song of the Siren here. Could be the counter to the Chronosphere gods.
What's going on here?
And, okay, we're way underway. Let's go. VP, Radiant, Secret, Dire. First match for both teams. Already looking to rumble. They're going to get the Soul Siphon off onto Weehot, charging into him. And then laying in some nukes on the Puppy. Both teams really want this bottom room. 5v5 off the bat. And then they're going to roll forward. Pylai dies in pretty far. Do they look to turn this? They've got a Lina stun, and they are going to catch him. He's in a compromised position right now. Auto attacks pretty good, but doesn't seem like they quite have the damage to get the kill. They also managed to grab the Weehaw Bounty Rune. Secret are going to get the double Bounty Rune grab now, as we will see Eternal Envy grabbing the top, but maybe it comes at the cost of a first blood. Lina stun off the mark. Don't tell me Zeus just walks away from this. No, Zuri! Zuri with the body block. 70, one more auto attack. He gets Mario, finishes him off. Bugger that he is. But they got the double Bounty Rune, so Secret probably not too upset.
Bit of a hectic start to the game. Secret really wanted the G ward, which is what got them in that bit of a odd, risky position. And I think overall for Secret, it maybe wasn't great because they actually used both Observer wards bottom. Puppy, the second one he planted, was only planted there so they could get vision for the D ward. So it wasn't really an ideal trade off for them. And very much the lanes from a start going to be a bit of a struggle for them. We see Misery taking a lot of harass from Lil, and it doesn't look like this is a lane he's going to be able to get a lot of experience from as a result.
Good news for your Darkseer. He's already hit level 2, so we'll have access to the Surge now. Get off to the jungle. Well, top lane, it's going to be the basically unkillable Void in the early game. Just generally, this hero just does not die with the Dazzle backing him up, so now truly unkillable, but they will roll on him, putting a little bit of harass out. Silent, this time walks it off. He comes right back.
Silent playing that carry role in the offlane, looking to pressure the Naga in the early stages of the game, and seems that's where some of the attention is going to be applied from VP, giving Nyx the lane where he can get some early farm and levels. Try to get Vendetta as soon as possible, then you can get moving around the map. You can really kind of not just be pressuring the Naga Siren in the lane, but also in the later stages with just
scout up the
levels.
Stacks, maybe you drop some wards, just be a real pain in the rear. Aggressive at the full camp, it's the bash on Pi. So he does opt for point and bash. You reckon this is just because the Dazzle's here to help him, so he doesn't need to play as defensively in terms of the skill build?
Yeah, absolutely. And this is not your offlane Void. This is Silent we're talking about. So he's going to go for, I think, at least one point in the time dilation because of how good a spell it is. But we're likely going to see
a bash max earlier on.
Yeah, probably at least 2-3. I mean, maybe even just straight up max it out like early on, as you just said. And also, the itemization is probably going to be a bit different. We're not going to see like a Vlad's Ag Scepter build. I don't imagine.
We've seen. I mean, there have been some interesting experiments in terms of the carry Void item build. I know Waga has been trying Radiance and even an early Vanguard before that. Yep. He's already completed PMS, so we're probably not going to see Vanguard.
I tried the Wagon build, and I was just like, eh, I have a Vanguard. That's great. Like, they can't kill me, but I was also not doing a whole lot of damage.
You can't be the only damage.
No, no.
That's where you have Alina, you do have a Death Prophet, so maybe a build like that's a little more viable, but yeah. Who knows? Maybe it'll be
you're
a Battle
Fury
Master.
You're trying to out-Naga the Naga when you go for the Radiance Manta build on Void.
Well, that's not a Battle Void's going to win. Not unless he gets kills. We'll see. Should be interesting how Silent chooses to play out the hero.
Izuri now finding himself in a 1v1 with the Phobos Nyx. Both players fairly low on mana here, although Misery will have a Soul Ring and just go the lane.
This is also going to be an Earth Spirit kind of camping out the mid lane. Looks like he might want to try to roll on the Death Prophet if she pokes her head out too far, but in the end, does trot back towards top. Pi just trying to find the openings.
Most interesting about this matchup is this is some of the first games on the new patch for these two teams. VP, I'm talking about, I don't think they played a single game on the new patch. Secret played WCA, but that was like the very, very early days of 6.86. So this is really, Outlander as a whole, like a big kind of showing for these teams as far as how they're going to be playing things.
Yeah, they got to put some of their strats on the table. I guess similar for EG as well. Caught the opposition a bit off guard with that Omni Knight grab. See Navi trying to also not so great.
Also exciting to see Enigma back for a little bit too.
Boulder kick committed. Pylai die could be in a bit. That's just kidding. So see you later.
Good roll. He rolled north. If he tried to just roll straight back to the 2-1 mid, he may
might have
lost. Yeah.
Very annoying. But the bounty rune's still going to the dazzles. They get a stun off on Puppy. Where's the bash when you need it? Time walks forward. Really committing for this one. But not gonna find it. While that was happening, it looks like there is a solo kill. DK Phobos finishing off Misery.
Dang.
Didn't even use the Spike Carapace there.
He had a Mango, I want to say, so I think that must have been like a Mango outplay where Doxia thought he had no mana and then popped the Mango, hits a stun.
Very big though. With that, you mentioned Nyx is the one that's gonna move around, and I imagine we see the Void at some point just get the safe play and get a little more secured farm and come soon. But for now, Nyx with a level 6. Be looking for a follow-up kill to really break this lane.
With Arcane Boots, like, Ys can go in for a Vendetta Impale. If one support rotates, like Alina, you're looking at another kill on the Doxia, which is... it's worthwhile. I feel like you're not really at the point where DK Phobos needs to be roaming just now. He's winning his lane and happy to kind of stay bottom, so if you can bring a support down there, you could find yourself in a really good position here for the early game for VP.
We haven't really talked too much about the overall strategic matchup between the teams, gods, and, you know, historically, carry Naga games, you get the Radiance, you go to the Manta, the Octarine, you spread the map, you basically never take fights unless you're really far ahead. Are you expecting that from Secret in this draft? Do you see any curveballs there, and then how do VP look to respond to it?
I think the curveball's going to be more likely thrown from VP, who can pressure towers a lot better with the Death Prophet. They've got a I wouldn't mean the support in itself, Lina not greedy, but a support who can also scale well. So I think we'll see probably Lina get a decent amount of farm prioritization goes on. And for Secret, taking fights is really difficult against Chronosphere, Time Dilation, Nyxed Assassin. So they're going to be playing keep away, focusing more on Split Push, focusing...
Top lane looks like they have rolled in. They're trying to make it on the Void, and Heech also laughs and jumps away. The bullshit escape artist in this game, I'll tell you what. My God. Nobody's dying.
Just wait till everyone's favorite ultimate comes into play. hear the song of the siren.
Want to hear the tears of the VP fans.
The song of the Twitch chat. You're going to know exactly what they'll be singing.
Things really heating up here. 2-0 the score. Still haven't seen the Nyx make his first rotation, but now he's looking for it on the mid lane, trying to jump the Zeus. Over a Vendetta, maybe even gonna scout the jungle out. And scouted just... oh, does he just walk all the way top? Where's our... oh, yeah. Courier? Let's see if timing syncs up.
Close. Soon.
Oh, hello, my precious! Easy grab for DK.
Reveals himself top, but I think a Courier at this stage is as important, even arguably more important than the kill there.
Die is going to roll down to the low ground immediately. TP's out, but so far the Earth Spirit has not felt very impactful. God,
yeah. He's been caught out a few times. I don't think he's done anything too wrong. It's just when you get caught out in the positions he's been, it forces you to use these defensive rolling boulders. So you want to generally be the one on the offensive harassing, using it to try and hit the mid laner with the rolling boulder to do some Zeus damage. But Not easy to this. Easier said than done.
Oh, jeez. My god, the damage coming out for this Death Prophet. Way too much. Pops the ultimate. Aren't really there in numbers, though. And he's going to be taken down by the Riptide rotation along with Weeha popping the ult.
He had 15 one charges and I think full or two bottle. He had full bottle charges and he was just trying to, like, maximize his use of those.
In the bottom lane, Lil Hardy on the run, Pylai Dai trying to get the kill, but out of spells at this point. And a little bit to the north, it looks like Nyx again on the hunt. Will he find anyone though? Lil's tried to sneak in, but in fact there's a third hero and he gets karate chopped. Pow, just like that, he's down for the count. Entry ward also has been planted. Ubos get caught out, they give him the old kick. They run.
Nice, go on to Lil. He's just trying to get a bit too much out of the Nyx rotation by staying around and not going back to base there, which cost him quite a lot.
So it is the Vlad's build.
Okay.
At least for now, Silent, very stock and standard Void. This seems to be, I'd say, overall the most popular build. I think we saw one Midas game, one Ags Rush out of China, which was the main region really favoring the Void. The Vlad's first was kind of... What do you think? What's your favorite build?
For offlane, I think without a doubt the Vlad's Aghanim Scepter is the best for farming Void, which is, I guess this is somewhere in between. I think Vlad's is still good because it is a decent farming item. But if you want to go like more raw DPS, you look other directions. Maelstrom's possibility. Pass, you see occasional Battle Furies, which
probably not Mask of Madness versus Zeus. That does not seem like the build.
Manta, like the Manta defusals, always not bad, although against these kind of heroes, it's not amazing.
Maybe more versus a dude. Trying to take over the wood. They still have a Chrono, yet to see that come into play. And Phobos, the map, which is generally where you want your Nyx to be, but the trade-off is nobody's bottom. So they're really trying to take advantage of their team fight. Pressure this mid tower. Everybody at base, Secret have decided to go on a group shopping trip right now. Four heroes chilling in the well. Do you like these shoes? They're pretty. Yeah, now on the run. The first man in the mid lane might be the first man back to the well. Tries to get the job done with the ult, and see you later. Well, the group shopping trip apparently not as successful. Apparently you need at least two heroes at the tower to defend. BP, just five-man Dota. We'll grab it.
He was just kind of praying he was in fog with the TPN. Because there was a Void Chronosphere there as well mid-lane. So the rest of the Secret's like, I'm not coming in to help you, we'll just get chronoed. And for the freebie going VP's way, and the tower on top of that, their lineup I think very much wants to just keep on pushing, snowballing, and trying to take all these out of towers by 20-25 minutes in, if possible. For a Secret, they need to hit item timings like the mech on Darkseer before they really raid a fight, even just getting more levels on Zeus, Earth Spirit as well, who's still level 4, so no Magnetize just yet. It's a lot trickier for Secret to fight without some important ultimates. BP just ready to go right now.
Like you said, they're constantly looking to fight, and they have yet to drop a Chrono. They're just using the Death Prophet ult. Phobos not finding Vendetta kills aside from the Courier, but threatening for them, and Secret, it seems the threat is as big an issue as the actual game.
He's already got Aether Lens up, so gets that extra range on the Impale, and...
Beef gets surged in, tries to make a jump here on G. Lil Hardy in position, but the stun's not going to connect. Good shoot by Misery. Slave comes over the top, almost dies to Laguna Blade. Highlight Dive rolls in to little effect, and now they turn onto FNG. Zeus ult is still ready, and they're going to try to turn on him. DK Phobos into position, then he gets stunned, but the Carapace is there to prevent Beef from getting out so easily. Weeha in the trees, TP out, and it's not. Oh, Weeha actually does get caught, ends up going down in the end.
Long
he would
TP.
Make it out of there.
Yeah, he had a long 4 second TP. This was TPing back the T1 bottom or something.
I guess he must have been, because otherwise I think he gets out there. And Eternal Envy, the one man not coming to the fights for Secret, he's off farming the junk. Long way to go until that.
And this is not exactly a great game for them to set anything up off of the Song of the Siren 2, so you can't look at this like, okay, yeah, Naga wants to farm Radiance, but come to a fight, use the song, then we set up a big team fight. At best, you kind of follow up with like a vacuum wall or a boulder smash. It's not like scary or guaranteed damage though, so I think the follow-up fight from the song will be won by VP, having the Dazzle to Grave and heal anyone who may get focused. They've got Nicolith Carapace, they've got the Death Prophet ultimate, they've got Void Chrono, so VP with a heavy advantage in any 5v5.
Path is now complete, and again, Exorcism being Pop G, just constantly spamming the spell on cooldown. It seems to be working. Each ult has led to either a tower or a couple of kills. Now Phobos sweeping around from the left, but immediately scouted out and bolted. Yeehaw, this is hell out of my lane, but I don't know if the Zeus is all that scary for VP, who continue to spam Shadow Waves onto the Death Prophet, keep on sieging. Ally sitting extremely far back. They do have a song available if they want to contest this, but Phobos has moseyed on towards mid. Does he have the damage to get a solo kill on Puppy with Vendetta? It's going to be the question. Maybe with the Aether Lens, it's close, but they really want the plus one. In position to potentially turn this could be the Naga, although she heads the pit to the left. And then the Chrono comes down, well placed to prevent Weeha from turning the fight. VP grab an easy pick, and they also get a tower, so objectives piling up at this stage. Oh, close call.
Zeus ulted for that, so that's now on cooldown.
Death Prophet ult also on cooldown, so probably doesn't lead to another objective, but at least lets them farm more freely.
So for VP, they're just chugging along. This train's going to keep pushing down towers, and I don't think Secret have the answer to breaks on the VP.
Train of destruction.
Yeah, it's slow and steady. They're getting there for VP, and get Phobos up a Blink Dagger now as well. He gets that scary initiation. Maybe want to actually go back and get Arcane Boots again.
Enter Bash mode. Eternal Envy forced the song and TP. Good thing he did, because Nyx was coming around from the north in that way. So Envy, that's the level 1 song. 3 minutes where he has to play extremely carefully. To what extent DP can look to punish that. We'll move the Dazzle up. Looks like they want to fully take over the woods now. Perhaps this is where Envy tries to go to the enemy woods.
It's the Misery Midas. He's gone for a Midas on Darkseer. This is very much a telltale sign. We are playing for the late game, the serious late
They're
game.
They're doubling down on the greed now. Yep. Radiant's a long way up. No real space for the Darkseer yet.
I think it's very much a mentality like you buy a mech now. It doesn't give you... It gives you a better teamfight, but your teamfight's still so much inferior to VPs that it's not really justified. So you pick up the Midas, you just play... You're trying to play towards a timing where Envy's going to have Radiance and some other items and just hoping you can stall out without a mech.
And so, Misery, despite the deaths, getting his experience for sure here. Big player if this goes. That aggressive ward down now. It will be dewarded. Never actually scouted, just see guessing that this jungle has been taken over by VP. And on the money, they'll get the deward. Still looking for a setup though. Chrono Laguna's ready and silent. He's creeping in. He wants a piece of that 8k MMR. Weehaw! Oh, bolt from the low ground. Another nuke. All time walk just to remove some of the damage. And Lil Hardy also going to get kicked and stunned. So instead, VP, oh, put the real aggression on the bottom lane. If you're going to five-man your jungle, we're going to take your tower.
Well, with Secret already moving here, recognizing that these heroes don't quite have the numbers.
Oh, Nyx under a sentry. Does get scouted out, but he still gets off the initial Vendetta. He then carapaces the Puppy Stun. Well played by him, but suddenly surrounded and nuked down. The wall is there. Secret. Be careful about this Void rotation, though. Death Prophet ult's ready. If they see it coming, they are going to get the hell out of Dodge. Be back off successfully. Grab the next kill. But it does force the Naga even to rotate. Not getting as much farming time as...
Still looking like a... Eastern Time Radiance, or the Relic for now. Out from Naga. He's
not getting killed, like even if he is rotating a bit. That's definitely.
He's actually building Sane with this cloak, considering getting the pipe for the team. Pipe is just so amazing against Zeus that it's one of the designs that if you want to go for an all out push and have the mech and all that, but when there's Zeus in the field, you're thinking mech plus pipe.
Could also very easily be a casual cloak. Still feels like great value this game. They want a pipe though, it's probably him building it. Don't see the Dazzle getting it, not normally a Lina item.
Yeah, really the only candidate to go have any sort of a decent timing for a pipe.
Creeping around, and Secret, you can sense that the Nyx effect is not even in the kills. It's in the way they're running for their lives from a hero that isn't actually quite there. Back. Constantly just looking for wards, scouting uphill with the bolt. Creeping and crawling. They're not in full rat mode yet. They are slowly building towards it.
VP just kind of maximizing what they can get. They've got Lean in the bottom lane, Death Prophet up top, just spreading their resources, getting farm all across the board. Phil Lane's actually picked up out of the cloak, so the range,
the silence, I guess, is like, a bit easier to get
a
off.
Bit easier, but I think a big part of this item is I guess I'm not entirely sure the Soul Siphon. I guess the cast range on that increases, but I think also quite importantly is the attributes to the item are really strong on Death Prophet. Magic resistance really good against the Zeus. You get the bigger mana pool, the HP regen as well when Secret's trying to spam you out. So
the damage isn't so. It's mostly your ult, your run.
Yeah, no, absolutely. So I think very looking just at that kind of like as a cost-effective transitional item that he can use, and considering VP wants to be able to pressure and take all these other towers now, they've done it with the tier ones, they're now working the tier twos. It's not a bad item to just pick up casually.
Who's the worst Aetherland barrier in the game? Phantom Assassin?
Probably worse than that even. There's probably some here that
I guess
the item does nothing for,
I guess
for,
the
right?
Dagger gets even more ridiculous.
I mean, Huska? Is that a consideration to that?
You could dunk from farther, dude. That sounds amazing. Come on, man. This is like the half-court MJ.
Yeah.
You know, or not even, like, more like a Vince Howard level of dunking shenanigans.
Naga Siren in snare range. That's what you get from it. There's definitely going to be a lot of...
That doesn't sound particularly appealing.
There's going to be some awful Aetherlands heroes out there.
I'm sure, Chad. Pull in on the top lane. Pilot Knight looking to make a go on Lil Hardy, but he got off the stun before the silence came through. Kicks the boulder back the other way. And then Pilot Knight suddenly on the run. They have a stun. They got him. And the zap for good measure. G says, no, that's my kill. And Lil says, no, that's my kill, you bastard.
Your Dragon Slave, my Crypt Zone, who's going to be more on time? That's like a minigame in itself. Have a hero like landing from Yules and seeing who can time their nuke better to get the KS.
And while VP are busy shooting the one fish in the barrel, slowly Piranha begins devouring its prey. Envy, Radiance Online, starting to grow up a little bit now. Our little Naga getting bigger and stronger by bit. Do you see a clock this game? And if so, what's the rough time here for VP?
For VP, they are at their strongest, I think, from like 20 to 30 minutes in before Naga gets item beyond the Radiance. But when they get past that, I still think they are okay. It's just like, this is the point where there's the biggest strength gap between where the two teams are at. It's just going to get a lot closer when you get to the late game. But Death Prophet, I think, scales still see well the late game. I think Nyx is going to be like a good hero that can transition well also, as far as being able to scout out the Naga Siren in these split push scenarios, trying to find the real one.
Oh, they want DK Phobos. G looking to join the engagement. He will finally drop the Chrono, gets the point though. There's the Spirit Siphon, and Puppy caught within Mand of going down, trying to save this one and turn it with the mech heal. Is it enough? Not sufficient. Silent able to time walk forward, and it's towards Weeha, who I think is going to have a bolt in a second. No, out of mana for the moment. Misery, Peggy the Laguna now trying to retreat out. Surge's back, Conehead can't make it home. And then Earth Spirit also duking it out with FNG in the trees. Who managed to chuck out a Magnetize. Ends up being a 2-for-2. And all the while, Jackie Mao sticking around, starting to add up the damage here. The Zeus comes through. There's the heal. Grave had it, but didn't get it off. And then a Song looking for a bit more. Just a TP out. He's happy. He's content. Gonna bite off more than he.
Safe, stable play coming out from Endy, and
big fight for Secret. Look at the net worth chart all of a sudden. I mean, their supports are very poor, but the cores are on ahead.
And the minus on Darkseer is starting to kick in now too, where you've got a decent amount of farm from him. He's got the mech on top of it. He's level 11. He's gonna have levels and levels and as well as farm more than what he'd have if he hadn't picked up this minus along the way. I think Secret supports as a whole, not entirely that farm dependent. Earth Spirit ridiculously good with Naga Interceptor, but often you see this hero running around with like Urn Arcane Boots and nothing else. In this case, Puppy with the Urn, and another hero who just needs levels and then he can save the core heroes using the swap. Pretty much all Naga games, you'll see two very poor supports, or at least one incredibly poor and one like kind of under farm
like
support.
Slightly under farm.
Yeah. You know, you see a Naga team, you're not expecting to have the farm support. That's more like the kind of take towers as a team kind of lineup where you'll have the more even farm distribution.
Yeah, Naga's driving a Lamborghini to work and you are just pushing a cart. But yeah, you both get there in the end. Things. Anna Rune top, very handy for the Death Prophet. We saw the Octarine Arcana duo last game. was that last game? I don't remember. It was such a long break. I think it was game two.
Yeah, the Navi draft.
Can be a fearsome combo. Doesn't have the... And they're thinking about a Roshan potential. Their head's near the pit. Just want to make sure he's there. All right. And there we go. The ghosts come out. Battle begins. Zeus ult to scout this Naga. No song though. Little march into the pit. Secret there. It doesn't look like they have too much interest in contesting. Four heroes backing up mid. Not the greatest. They've got the one ward outside the pit, but that's about it.
And the one hero who they need to contest for Roshan's axes in the flanks.
The Aegis will go the way of Virtus Pro, and now they're moving in with the smoke. Do they want to commit into this? And about face! Let's get the hell out of here. Back off immediately. We even want to go forward. They swap G in. Ghost's about to return. The return is now complete in secret. Realizing this is not the fight they're looking for. Puppy through the trees, just looking out and shoot them. Not so lucky though is Weeha, who gets caught inside a chronosphere. This could be big if they can finish him off. That's probably going to work from the south, the void from the north, and that is Lil Hardy securing the kill, getting vengeance for the Death Prophet to steal a step from earlier. Is there a song ready? 8 seconds to go. He's silenced anyway. He's not going to get it off. Oh, secret hemorrhaging crucial core kills here inside their own base. There's a back wall to turn it. A roll forward from the ember. He gets up the magnetize on the entire enemy team. Then the Zeus don't come through. All of a sudden, they may have salvaged the fight. G, low, can they crack that Aegis? The double Yules from both heroes. And looks like he may go down. Kick. He jukes. No, it barely grabs him. Then they lose the Aegis. Then they kill him again. They're prepping for it. They want to give this one a go. The bolt comes out. G throwing out nukes and then heading to the south. Weeha continues to lay into him. Just retreating slowly but surely. There's even an invis rune down below. Keeps on going. This kick will miss. G will survive, but secret with a surprisingly strong turn there in the base.
Yeah, they made that look a bit easier than I would have expected to start defending. It is still VP who are, at least for the most part, forward in terms of taking objectives, taking the Aegis first and moving towards the mid tier 2 tower, which they don't ultimately get, but killing off the Naga as well as Zeus, and that was a buyback from Zeus, I believe.
Yeah,
buyback from Zeus, which means that was not exactly quite the hold it maybe looked like for Secret when you have something expensive as that. So for VP, you put a buyback on cooldown on a hero like Zeus, and now your next exorcism almost guaranteed to be able to take a T tower.
Good news, while that was all happening, Courier did get sniped, so a little extra gold going the way. Phobos up, and this is also why the supports are so poor, gods, is the constant need to plant sentries everywhere to deal with the Nyx infest. A defensive grid they've assembled here to try and protect the Naga as much as possible. Prophet, though. It's gonna walk in. They get a sentry down on the high ground, but the Yules is there to start things off. The double Yules coming down, all kinds of setup, and no connection. They can't find a single hero with that. FNG may even end up going down. The blink forward back is gonna bring in FNG, who gets off the grave. G also able to retreat. I think they will survive at least for now, but. Oh, silent. The Chrono. Here we go. Not content with that initiation for a better one. Moving forward, but Envy running his tentacles back through the dire jungle and retreating, and the song up. He aren't finding open.
Yeah, that's one good way to. If Naga doesn't get caught in the Chrono during a team fight, you can just kind of song to reset and negate that. From that ultimate to some extent.
Island, he's gonna Iron Talon his way through the trees, gets up the Chrono and it connects on two, but he gets boulder kicked right as this was happening. Then the swap out from Puppy trying to save the Zeus. Not gonna happen. The boulder returns, the back wall's there, but Misery caught in the middle of four heroes. Bash runs silent on the first hit, looks to go. The Magnetize still rolling into a Misery. Caught out will end up falling. It's a twofer. The Naga ult is available, but the Death Prophet ult has only just begun, so that's gonna be a tier two. Maybe even try to put some damage on this tower, and the best news for them is Envy is back home, trapped inside his own base, stuck in the basement, unable to slow down his push. Oh no, Ags is about to come out for Silent, has the item now. The next time a mistake like that is made, Secret might have to deal with two ultimates in a fight. There's the Yules, they're looking for more, the song is forced out, it's only to protect Pylai Dai, the support Earth Spirit.
catch from VP is just too damn strong. And I think one of the really nice things about the Aether Lens on the Death Prophet has been that increased range for the Yule's catch. So, because they've got such great follow-up for the Yule's with the Insta-Silence from Death Prophet, they've got the Lina Light Strike Ray, the Impale from Nyx. They just keep catching and getting pick-off after pick-off, which leads into the towers. I think it's a very underrated element of push strats is having that catch as well to go with it. If you're not killing heroes, sometimes even if you've got an amazing push strat, the other team can defend.
Oh, Puppy. He's out pretty far, but VP with all the ults on cooldown. Not quite ready to go. They will isolate Phobos, but Phobos stands his ground against five heroes, and then he doesn't. And he... Now they have the eggs.
Yeah, as so... another tool for catching. Doesn't have a blink dagger to go with this, but time walked and... Running on in, maybe gonna suffice it for silent.
Lens dazzle. What's everybody
all
getting for
lenses? Yeah, if you're winning games with like triple, quadruple Aether Lens, then
four Aether Lens. All right, silent. Where's yours? Come on, join
and
the clan.
Most importantly, all three of those Aether lenses paired with a Yule Scepter. That's three heroes with Yules plus Aether Lens. So
and now an Octarine.
Well then. This is some hard to defend push that's going to be coming soon. Secret have got Octarine soon on Naga, not quite there to go with the Radiance, but not sure if that's going to cut it by itself.
He needs a lot more time, it feels like. They have so much catch. Yules, as you mentioned, a great setup, and don't know to worry about the Nyx constantly off the map, and a lot of heroes who simply cannot leave the base. Zeus, easy prey. The supports, obviously, it's Darkseers, a little vulnerable on Wawiha. Docked right now, that dirty cockroach. Phobos knows there's probably sentries and there are some heroes missing. Take it easy instead, jaunts through the route towards the end.
So, Secret, overall game plan has got to just be try and keep Envy alive and keep lanes pushed as much as possible. Avoiding these ganks is always going to be tricky just because I don't think they can really have detection everywhere. Picking up a gem may just be a necessary item for them. Even though they've got the Zeus, I feel like they may have to just make that big jump so they can deward their side of the map. Because right now, VP have Vision of Heroes, which they've got great deep wards in this dire jungle for. I don't think Secret can really do too much on the map, so I think taking out the VP Vision is going to be very important for them before.
So Envy did sense the pressure top and off the ultimate to get out. It's still the level 2 ult. You will have the Octarine. How much longer do you reckon for P? Are they approaching a timing where they really want to go break the base? Content just trading farm?
Can trade farm okay. Probably the next Aegis will be like a good time for them to go high ground.
Oh, they do get those off. Phobos though, still hunting. Misery with that Midas is quietly going to rack up the farm, so...
Gosh, that's such a good BKB.
This is the
game.
Haves and have-nots game.
Yeah, I don't know if Misery considers getting a BKB, but it's so nice against the Yule's stun follow-ups that VP are kind of spamming out. Silence from Death Prophet.
Might still die anyway to a Chrono Laguna, but is now an Aghanim's upgraded one, but even forcing that out on yourself is valuable. Anyone buy Glimmer Cape anymore? Like all I see is Aether Lens now.
You know, this is new item.
Good. I guess the situations are few and far between.
You're against like a Necrophos or something. It's like, okay, I'll buy a Glimmer Cape now.
Maybe if you have a Winter Wyvern. Oh wait, that.
Another new
Winter Wyvern
is added to the pool.
I thought he got deleted from Dota.
Somebody had to make room for
I miss Articuno. Assault is activated, and Envy is a little nervous.
He knows Nyx is there now, but the fact Nyx didn't immediately jump him shows Envy that Nyx did not have friends with him. Gonna be just forced to continue to play on the back foot, and here comes VP, ready to go grouped up mid once more, and it is an Aghanim Scepter Void, so very short cooldown on Chronosphere. Even if they just get a pick off, force a buyback, and then they don't get a lane to Rax here, it's still very beneficial in Virtus Pro.
Head up to push. Take a fight, but smoke. Hold on for a little. To dodge it, they sit back, and they are still getting Envy on the map. in that bottom lane, the rest of the team starting to become the have-nots more and more, and did get the gem, as you mentioned, wanting to see that. Better ability to deward the map, but found a lot of these aggressive ward DQ. And Envy. Walks right into the void. Is he gonna go for this? Gets the bash off. Oh no, what's gonna happen? Song and then just keeps away, and it's still level 2 ultimate, but yeah, with the Octarine complete now.
Sound close to using Chronos for there, just want to try and wait a few more seconds to let his teammates closer. Instead of getting
free
a kill,
rush.
Yeah, they'll get free rush. Mention probably time where they can go for another high ground seed. They don't have to, very much their lineup going great into the late game. Lina as a support has surpassed the Void, but this is kind of what you want from a Lina going into the late game stages. It's kind of a similar hero to Visage in that sense when played as a support. The hero benefits so much from items and scales ridiculously well that you'd much rather Lina be farmed than your Nyx. And as far as the Void versus Lina, when the Void's going for an Axe Vlad's build, you're not looking at a scaling hard carry faceless Void. So this is actually like the ideal scenario in farm distribution for Virtus Pro right now.
A lot of ways. The Nyx still does a ton already with the items he has.
Yeah.
Sherry's only 9k net worth. To see that Lurker Aghanim with Aetherlands. I haven't actually seen the Aetherlands Aghs combo yet.
I actually think it's so good, like in how it changes how you have to play against the hero, kind of like the tree and Aghs. I'm surprised it's not bought a bit more because of like how much it increases what you can do on the hero.
So, this might be a game where we see it.
There's so many other items that you want and sometimes quote unquote need to get. Quite likely a follow-up item to where he's at now could be Aghs Scepter.
Continues to slowly work towards that next item, but the Octarine complete, 3k banked up. Very far behind. A very slow game through the mid stage. Generally, you would say the Naga team be happy with that. Just how much VP have farmed on everyone. Dazzle. Not enough. Still leading in terms of net worth at this stage, and still no real threat on the tier 2s, let alone the base. So, handling the split push just fine. You're not Naga illusion. Down mid. So, and down the hatches, they turtle up in the base, and yeah.
The ward. I think that VP saying, hey, we know what's there. On to you.
Hey guys, I think there are racks up this hill. Probably hit them.
And Lina with travels means they can, because Secret always going to try to do a bit of split push whenever VP group up. To try and
this Lina is
take a high ground push.
Farm. Even more farm than the Void at this point.
Lil.
Whether it's Visage or Lina, he's always finding his items. G, now at long last, going to breach the base. Arches up to high ground. Envy slowly trying for the split push, but he's not even at the creep wave top lane, and there's still a tier 2 there anyway, so VP are going to force the issue. Let's see if Secret stack a lane or Axe. They try to contest G. Now with the range down, turning onto the melee, they're looking for the clean objectives. Puppy with the quick swap out, but Weeha in danger to that Aghanim's Laguna Blade. G sticking around a bit. Does Envy look to come back? Is this the time to strike? Not. Axe about to fall. The silence on Weeha. Blink forward from DK Phobos. Just gets off the mana burn. Tries to send a packing back towards the base. They have not finished the melee, but what they couldn't do quite with the ultimate, they're going to attempt to do with auto attack. Silent still here. Blink Dagger actually forces out Misery's BKB for nothing. They didn't actually chrono and then just walks away. At long last, Envy comes home. Not split pushing, and they are sticking around.
They'd love to get this melee reactor for it. If they back off, it's going to heal up a bit. They've just forced out some spells from Secret. I think they do want to go back in. Play the Naga illusion, so I don't
know. No Darkseer BKB.
Yeah.
This would be the time. Go in, Lil. Auto attacks will get the job done. The kick comes through, connects on 2, and then Misery blinks forward. Back wall isn't sufficient. The Chrono will complete air ball, but it does zone Weeha back a little bit. At least perhaps that's enough. Lil Hardy kept alive by the grave. They have lost their Aegis, and Envy looks to get active here. Has the sound if they want to just get Puppy ever so low. Can they finish him off silent? He wants to go for it. Finally, Magista just get the kill, and Envy heads to the north where G is just chasing him. Now the BKB, and he kills him even through the song. Sleep on that, you bastard. Now Weeha. Soul Siphon going strong, he's in trouble. Phobos there with the Vendetta, pokes him in the rear, and Secret have lost a lane of Rax. Actually, I think the melee's still barely surviving, but they gotta be going back for this at this point with 4 dead. Three still alive, and Death Prophet ever so healthy. And she's almost got an ultimate up, I believe. Yeah,
yep.
Has it ready?
Green already.
Is this? Oh, they don't have the tier twos, so it'll be one lane.
Even just for this low HP melee rack, it's not. Yeah, it's worth using it to secure melee racks at this stage of the game. Secret, put him under some more pressure, and G's going to do just that. Not the most productive exorcism.
Get those huts.
Oh yeah,
easy money.
That is a lot of money for G. 3,700 gold banked up. Gonna grab the tier two as well. No Sawn at this stage. BKB making the difference there, and I think Envy was expecting that play.
He is caught up and overtaken Naga Siren now.
Death Prophet is still out farming a Naga at 38 minutes. That is extremely impressive.
Of Naga available, but you really, I think he, with a Manta, that fight there possibly could have been held, but like first Naga illusions go out, they just get instantly cleared, and then he's gonna wait a decent amount of time before he can resummon them, even with an Dream 4.
Trying to get bottled up a bit more. Naga illusion spreading, but only over their side of the jungle as Lil Hardy is gonna engage on the puppy. You are not running from that Aether lens, but maybe they can turn the fight with a blink forward from Izzy. The Chrono gets the point again, and Misery actually walks into it, but they need some damage going into this Chrono. It's barely coming from FNG. There's the swap out. Puppy trying to survive through it. The Magnetize deployed onto Silent, caught on his own. Time walks away towards the south. G has no exorcism yet, and FNG is going to grave himself up in the tree line while the song comes out, tries to prevent anyone from retreating Secret. They want to take out the trash. G in danger. Silent gonna blink forward. The boulder kick of not time quite right with the song. So he'll be okay through this. Now BKBG tries to go to town, and it looks like Secret just want to ignore him, kite him, and come back for him last. Exorcism ready in 8 seconds. Is that even gonna be a difference maker at this stage? Doesn't look like it. Heads to the north. Net comes through. Bolts there. They will lose G as well, and it's gonna be a full five-man wipeout for nothing aside from a tier two top. I believe they either recovered a gem or got the VP one as well. 8,000 gold! Like one fight.
Yeah, that's a huge, huge turnaround. Not that much going the way of Naga Siren, but still a Naga Siren who's kind of continuing to maintain pace towards the late game. And
they just get overconfident with the easy success they had in the mid lane.
Yeah, overconfident, and it was Secret getting a nice jump to start things off. Lina got put in a bad spot from the get-go. The Chronosphere kind of came in, but wasn't able to really salvage the situation or keep Lina alive. So I think just a few small things adding up early on in Secret. And then VP just kept trying to take the fight despite being down in numbers.
So here's a fun item that we haven't seen all that much of. Most Earth Spirits being in a pretty hard support role. But an Aghanim Scepter pile I'd die.
Ooh, well. Pushing high ground versus that. They've got the swap. They've got the vacuum to go with it.
Suck you in and kick you into the fountain. What is the total range on that between the pole and the back?
Pretty big.
It's like what, like 2,000 plus?
It depends a bit because the way the boulder smash works is it's from like your body, so you can theoretically do it with them like from when they're behind you, and it gets that bit of extra range increase. You can also get Aether Lens if you want on the Earth Spirit, then you can increase the range by even more. So Earth Spirit's gonna be fun to push in.
More BKBs maybe.
More Aether Lenses. They've got five, have they? No, okay, Silent.
I think four has been working pretty well. It does seem like they need a little more damage in the Chrono, though. If they don't have Exorcism, you saw in that last fight,
yeah.
Void couldn't even get a single kill out of it.
Yeah, Void's solo kill potential isn't there, and Lean is kind of the kill for the VP side. X had a point booster, so likely seeing Scepter. Octarine's also really good on the hero, but I think Axe more likely.
Oh, because of that fight, not only did they get a huge jump in gold and experience, but just as importantly, Secret got a chance to push the lanes out. Now, you can see all three lanes either at the river or past it. Gotten control back of their own jungle, some defensive wards planted down. Heroes are being forced to deal with the split push, and map control for Secret overall has improved dramatically. Constantly illusion streaming towards the base, towers being chipped away at. You're gonna have the work cut out for them to equalize things.
And Envy's just creep skipping with the illusions has been point throughout this game, so.
And that maybe sets up for kill opportunities. They kick in on mid.
Hard split. Quite likely the next Roshan going to be very important for both the two teams. I think it's a kind of fight location where Secret have these big team fight spells in vacuum.
They see this. Silent's hunting. He's getting close. He's going to assume that Envy has... Oh, no, maybe not. Time walk in.
Whoa.
Ooh, 5 seconds on the boots of travel.
Close.
This could actually end poorly for Turtle Envy, but Puppy is here in position to either get the swap out or at least save his buddy. Lil Hardy getting caught out. Dive dropping quickly to the illusions. Matches the chuck out of Laguna. It's on to Puppy. Still waiting for that chronosphere from Silent. The wall gets to put everybody already so low. Time walks out of the damage. Still waiting for the chrono. He just can't find an opening. He finally drops one. It's only a Weeha. There's no damage going into it. Death Prophet against the world as the rest of VP get pulled apart. Four now down. And they're going to try to cage the Ghost Lady and stun there. A lot of heroes tanking the damage. And G surrounded. Boulder's getting kicked around, an army of Naga Illusions swatting away at her. She still survives, heads to the north, turns with the nukes, throws Boulder wildly off the mark from Pi, but the ghosts are coming back soon. Almost gets two more kills with that last nuke. Still tanking through everything. The Turtle Envy is throwing at him. Might even kill all the backliners if they're not careful. Now the Spirit Slave is going in again, the net, and it continues to just toss out nukes. Nobody can get close to G. One man wrecking crew here, but at long last, they wiggled him down. He still gets the BKB, which he now pops. He throws out yet another wave of ghosts, and they're afraid. The rain boss, it's taken too long. The Lil Hardy's come back in, and he wants to get involved. Finds the kill, manages to bring down the Naga. That's an unstoppable streak. And Puppy, although he's been pulled back, may actually go down. Lil's there with the quick grab, gets the long range, and then the stun, the nuke. It all began with G, and it ends with two very unexpected kills and creeps just storming down mid to finish what the heroes could not.
A long fight like that, and then suddenly it's like creeps just pouring in your base and tier 4's taking damage, but holy cow, what a team fight coming out from G.
Are they just going they're going all the way tier 4's now?
Exism's like back up soon, so I mean, so much of that fight was done IG without exorcism towards the end.
He just fought off 4 heroes by himself, and if you look at his net worth, he's not even the most farmed hero in the game. My god, G played that brilliantly, but the Prophet, she is scary. Are they going straight for it?
I
could
definitely
go for the bottom lane of Rek if they want to play the safe, but EP, they have decided that this is the time to strike. So tier 4s are going to get worked down. The Zeus ult comes out in combination with the back wall, almost killing off everyone. Then they chrono. It's only on Weeha. Again, the chrono's not really the best here. Not getting a single kill, and they are going to pull the Zeus almost out of the chronosphere. Pylai Dai attempting to save him. Everybody now retreating. Time walk back from Silent. Misery charging forward. Naga has the song ready. Can she get in position? This could be the time to strike. Knowing the Death Prophet ult's about to finish. Silent, Phobos caught out. Envy swarming around, threatening to go in, but afraid to go in at the same time. And isn't going to end up doing it. Instead, it's Phobos who decides to take the aggressive maneuver. Get the stun as well as the mana burnout on Misery. Forces Puppy to swap him and retreat the hell out. What's going on this game, guys? They just tried to drone it. they haven't gotten either lane, and they're just like, we can end this game right now. Did not happen.
Yeah, there's a couple heroes dead. You're thinking we can get some actual damage done, put Secret under even more pressure, and you're just getting kind of frustrated with being delayed in the other games. At this point, you're thinking, like, all it takes is one successful team fight and an exorcism, and you win the game. Taking all the lanes of Rex is going to be a lot harder because you're against Naga Siren. Naga's going to be split pushing, creep skipping waves, and he just recognized that this next Aegis, possibly a game-winning Aegis, which they don't even have to go for Mega Creeps with. They go straight with the throne, Aegis and Cheese, and
the thing that scares me, if I'm Secret, is the Chronos haven't even really been that good this game, at least not lately. Yeah. Mostly been one hero Chronos, they haven't been able to kill the heroes trapped within. God forbid Silent gets, like, even just two heroes, and there's no defensive swap. I could just end it.
Well, indeed. 5k gold near this top lane, see what he looks to decide to do. Misery piling a lot himself, and that's a bit of a sign that Secret maybe slightly undecided what they want to get, or just looking for some of these big late game items and not wanting to commit to them while they don't have buybacks just yet. He's gonna rush into any kind of a push right away off the Aegis cheese. If they want to try and wait towards the end of the cooldown for it, they could have another kind of key item here or there.
Death Prophet is well into the luxury purchases. Next, 4,600. Is this where you look towards your refresher?
Sure.
For the game ending combo?
AC, if you think you can, if you want like a good item for the throne.
This could be the clincher. Forget about items.
Yeah, the runes.
What a time for an arcane rune. Well, I think it's what, 75 seconds?
For the exorcism, yeah.
I believe so.
Oh, it's already, 76 seconds. Be damn ridiculous. Seeing the duration, it's very like, high uptime.
You can just pop it, force everything out, and then go again with the second ult, try to win the game. That might be what VP are looking for. They've left the lead up top, but as you pointed out, she does have BOTs, so can be the plus one that joins the fight a bit later on. At the very least, they're going to want to pop an exorcism before this rune expires, if possible.
And commits the heart that means he doesn't have buyback, but I think probably realize like they lose a hero or two, it's not going to be about buying back to keep yourself in the game. It's going to be this awesome situation.
VP change their approach a bit, not going to try to beat their head against the mid lane. Instead, they are going to push all the lanes out and maybe even just go bottom. Undecided. They want to get all the lanes going their way, but Secret recognizing they have to at least put a little pressure somewhere. Poked their heads out top. So they want to go very in the dark right now. There's only two wards for Secret, and one of them just doesn't see anything relevant.
Imagine Lil might be telling his team, like, I really want to be Gibby right now. Have for this last push, although. What item slot limited?
Killing blow. Been in the base.
Seeing Lil smoke, I think they realize that Secret's going to be spending time and effort pushing this top lane, so they might be able to get a pick off. It's gonna happen for them right now. So far, Secret doing a good job avoiding fights and not giving you that opportunity to end the game off of the Aegis and Cheese.
I gotta tell you guys, it's gonna be a long night with the way these games are going. Our second match about to clip the 50-minute mark. It still feels like if Secret play their cards right, it could go a lot longer, but Phobos is here. He's going to break the smoke up on the high ground. There's no ward. It's a complete airball from Secret. Great positioning and awareness. Secret blowing a crucial resource here. It does allow Envy to get out on the map bottom, but again, tier 2s are still up mid and top, or in bottom lane rather, for EP. So it's not like Naga can threaten the base trade. She is going to have to come home, defend, and protect her nest.
The VP just bouncing around from lane to lane.
Phobos starting this one off. He blinks in. He looks for the stun. Misery is able to BKB. Tang's on for now, but geez, managed to get the exorcism off. Silent still waiting to deploy that chronosphere. The ghosts begin to go to work. Wailing away at this tower. When does Envy look to make his move? G, very healthy, then Silent, he engages, he's managed to fight a couple of key heroes. Pi just pulling the Naga towards himself, but she's still trapped within the chrono during this time. Silent may go down, but they've already gotten a lot of damage out. Zeus will bypass, trying to hang on to the base. There's a roll forward, big commitment from Pilot Knight. Shiva's now pumped by G, and FNG's gonna have to back himself out. Lil turning with the nuke, stunning up Pumpy. Silent still time walking out, everybody lives. VP, stay alive for now. Envy's got the song. When's he gonna let it go? He gets silenced as he walks up the hill. Then the spirit siphon goes to work. Phobos may have a stun soon. They have managed to crack that Aegis and they look for a bit more. Rolling back, Pylite Eye scatters. They're still waiting on another ultimate from the Death Prophet. It's gonna be a bit longer. And they have lost their Lita, who at this point might be the second most important hero on the entire team. Silent, no chrono just yet. G gets caught out. There's a buyback on the Lita. The stun beautifully placed by Phobos. He's caught out too. They're clearing out the wave. Secret are running out of ammunition. Oh. There's no swap. There's no vacuum wall.
And some of these refreshers are coming up soon. Yeah, refresher for Death Prophet. Void got Chronosphere back just because of the Aghanim Scepter cooldown. I don't even know. Does Death Prophet even need to use a refresher? How far away is the
I think she waits for the next exorcism and then uses it
double
right
ulti.
After that to win the game.
Yeah, you've got double ulti. You've got Chronosphere.
Oh, Courier also sniped. 4,200 gold. What did it have? Oh, that's the completed Shiva's. I guess not the biggest deal. But just more economic damage to an already impoverished Secret backline.
I don't really think VP want to continue to slow roll this one now that Death Prophet has kind of reached critical mass. Slowly getting there as well.
You haven't even seen her final form yet. still got item slots.
Oh, she wants Secret to get
more.
She can
courier that refresher and have more items, by the way.
That soul siphon scaling. It's like, yeah, you guys just get some more items. Get more tanky. Don't worry, my soul siphon, it stays relevant.
She is not going to waste any time in letting the salt go. Secret may have to all in on just trying to combo him down. But that will not be an easy task. Where is the Earth Spirit? Out and kick when you need it. They're going to start off with the swap, but he gets off the BKB. So the Air Spear can't do much to G during this time. The back wall comes through. It catches out three heroes, but Death Robin just throws herself in the air, and the Ghost continue to go to work. The Chrono again. It only catches Weehawk silent. Not even able to kill him. Gets turned into a boulder inside the Chrono protected. For now, G is low. G might actually drop to this one. The Zeus finishes it, but Secret, perhaps they've overextended through this. Buying back Insulin, the Death Prophet, who has a refresher, sells the phase boost, buying the BOTs, coming right back with round two. You've committed your combo, and I am angry. This is spooky. She's going for the throw now. Forget about the hero kills. G wants to finish off this game, but heroes are getting cleaned up on the backlines of G. If he dies back here, this could actually be a gigantic throw. He says the second BKB, trying to retreat out, getting body blocked by Misery. He knows this is a big opportunity. They find the net. Where's the backup? Void's coming in. They're going to lose G, possibly throws himself up in the air. He goes down. It's a dieback on the Death Prophet. BP. Oh, making this game spicy. Too spicy.
Oh.
They didn't even get a lane of Rex guns. The throw still has a tier 4.
Not like this, VP. Not like this. That is a huge gold loss for Nyx for Death Prophet.
Look at the graph.
And it's dipped back to even. This is like, your Naga's just like, okay, we've held over the hardest part of the game to hold. Same time, you're also saying, okay, I'm 6 slotted guys, so we're not like we're going to be farming up a storm and getting super scary late game, but Zeus, Doxia are probably the heroes who have to scale a bit more as time goes on. Like, you get an Octarine on Zeus, you're looking at a lot more firepower, but they know with Death Prophet down, this is a time where they just damage, possibly even threaten the high ground.
At the worst, she respawns by the time they get to the base, and it looks like the Venge was looking for a jump on Phobos. Uppy getting aggressive here, has to access that level 3 swap. The range gets ridiculous. Secret, their turn to march forward. Down the middle lane they go. 50 seconds on the Naga. This will be a tough hold, and they have managed to start it off with the swap. Kick comes through, but Phobos, Yul's gonna get perched off there. He is able to blink away. Violent trying to force them back. He gets to work on the bottom lane. Secret, not sure that they're going to take this as an answer. Now the Chrono Spear, they do manage to isolate Misery, but he's really tanky, even through the Laguna Blade Chrono combo. And now there's no Chrono Spear for the defense. But it seems Secret are going to play it safe. Got more item slots on Naga. Envy still got some Courier Micro in them, and well, they get a tier 3. But now, perhaps the real rat game can begin.
You really tried to all in and end the game there with that the Death Prophet refresher, and having the pipe against the Zeus, just one of those small things. You don't really expect your 5 position Dazzle to have a pipe, but you know, it would be a very important item. Not having the BKB on Lina as well. Magic damage just tears them up and also guarantees that the vacuum's landing always. You've got just one BKB across the VP side.
It does seem like they're looking for more now, as we see a BKB pretty much done a little. He seems to want to save for buyback first. Phobos appears to be grabbing his own next. Could be an egg. Actually, it is an egg. They'll have the triple BKB threat soon. Ready if she doesn't. Is a really good item this game. Maybe could be the game changer.
You can prevent Darkseid getting a huge vacuum wall off in these fights through your BKBs, or prevent Zeus from doing a huge amount of damage. Try and bring him down during your durations.
The walls have been really big in a lot of these fights. Usually, I would say 3 heroes caught on average. And they get all the illusions before VP are able to retreat.
At some point, VP is going to be thinking, we need a bit more wave clear, something like the Mjolnir on the Void. You can't just be going for this.
It's not even really that much single target damage with a... And it is the big downside to this particular build. With, I mean, what is that, like 12,000 plus gold spent on utility and initiation?
He's just playing, it's an item build that plays around the ultimate. The MKB kind of the one exception.
Oh, that long range swap from Puppy is going to force out a BKB on G. Pops the Shiva's, trying to turn this one. Misery rushing in. He really wants to go. He backs and only grabs FNG. And they... No buybacks. No, they're on cooldown for a couple. Sure, Secret actually... overcommit. Could be a couple buybacks online, and they're gonna walk up to the high ground. Ah, let the rat begin. Solve the heroes, kill the Rex. then run the hell away. But Envy has been caught out on the retreat. They can pull him back, perhaps. He does get pulled by the Air Spirit, but not all that far. Laguna Blade comes in. There is no for a long time, and now the Chrono. That one was the one they were waiting for. Silent, able to cloak down the Naga, has the buyback, but really doesn't want to be using here. Pi looking for the rollout, but Void on the hunt. Puppy then swaps him to the south, desperately trying every shenanigan in the book to save him, and Envy has bought back. He's ratted out in the mid lane while this is going on. Weeha is going to drop. Envy going for the secret tactics here, trying to finish off Rex. Maybe even going to rotate on the bottom lane, but it looks like Death Prophet's in pursuit. If they could just manage to catch this Naga, it could be the difference maker. Seems like he'll make it out. Misery not so lucky. The illusion swarming towards the well, and FNG should be able to survive through this. Meanwhile, Nyx wants Bounty Rune. I think he's actually Scouting Roche. Oh, FNG going to die in the well. No, he'll be okay. But they get the lane of Rex with the buyback, so yeah. Secret, one big step closer towards equalizing and even pulling ahead in terms of the creepy equilibrium.
Now VP are going to just feel like they're in that pressure spot where they've got to make a move. Even though their late game's like pretty solid, they've got great team fight around Void and Nyx. They're going to be happy that they're losing Rex and just losing ground to the Naga Siren team, so.
And if they can't punish the Envy buyback before it cools down, then he could just do that all over again. Under VP, feel like the clock is ticking. Good chrono from Silent, though, and we can see that Void is still a game changer if he manages to find the right ult.
And they've fantastic spells to dump in the Chronosphere with Lina. Axe Nyx has that super long range on Impale and Mana Burn, which means he can get a lot of spells off as well. Hitting like more than two of these Chronospheres moving forward is going to get trickier and trickier.
And normally, even if you do, they get turned into a boulder, they get swapped out, their song is there. It is a very tough Void game, in fairness to Silent. But the way the game's developing, it also feels like... Oh, excuses, they need big ults from him.
They need some huge pickoffs as well. Like, using a Chronosphere for like, a key hero pickoff is definitely justified.
No, the other thing we used to see, guys, was the Refresher Void. Mana has been more of an issue, but he does have Eggs as a counter to Bend, where you Chrono, she swaps them out, you Chrono again, and then you kill the target. Not sure if we're going to
I'm not sure with the Refresher, because it's now the double burst, right? It doesn't give you any intel. I'm not sure if you can stay in the mana pool for.
What is Silence mana pool? I think he probably has enough with the Eggs. Yeah, I believe he does.
Action all the stats. 300, 600, I think you're looking at 375,
but he'd ideally want some mana boots.
It's about 1,000 mana to use double Chronosphere.
At the same time, we've seen they're also lacking damage in Chronosphere, so does he just get more damage instead and try to maximize the first one? It's a slot game here for VP as well.
I'm definitely still a fan of the Mjolnir just because of the illusion clearing capabilities that the item helps grant you.
They're on the hunt for Phobos. The Blink Shivas is there to cancel any sort of... and now they are going to follow it up with a boulder stun. I think we really want to go on that. In fact, they want to get out quickly because Void is angry and hunting. Misery does get thrown up in the air, but manages to pop the BKB as he retreats. And now the song, Envy, retreating all the way back. This is let's get to the tier fours, boys. That's where we'll hold the line. Song on cooldown for a minute. A bit less than a minute, I should say. Is that going to be enough time for VP? By the time they get to this tower bottom, I believe we will see one more song available.
Yeah. It's something they just kind of have to accept that almost any time they want to push, there will be a song.
Silent. This is where you love that new time walk. Encounter the Zeus, but Silent gets stunned. He's taking a lot of damage, needs some help during this time. He is going to lose the Aegis off the bat, and that means there's no real defensive play for VP as Will Hardy drops low. Manages to get off the stun, stays alive for now. They are going to duke this one out. It's time to rumble, and it's going to be Lil going down. Has to buy back dead for 110. May have no choice but to spend it, because this could be the game deciding fight. The Chronosphere comes through. The Ghosts are going all the while. Misery's, though, tanking the entire time. Can they get a single kill out of this Chronosphere? It really doesn't seem that way. The stun onto Envy. Envy surviving. Then the swap out for Puppy, keeping him alive through it all. They throw the nuke out to the south. Envy able to live. The boulder kick just off the mark. FNG gets caught in the trees. Secret at the whole squad available, and VP are on the run. They're routing them. FNG will be next, three down. TP, is he gonna make it out? No, the song catches him again. Envy slams the door. The BKB is available now, but G may really regret having not used it as he gets nuked to smithereens. Down he goes. Four are dead, three with Vivek, and they may all have to use it to avoid losing their base.
Yeah, the secret is out, and they beast moding their way back into this game right now, and Curtis Pro just running out of steam. They had such a good early game. They had a 10k net worth lead at one point. But Secret, all it took was like one good high ground defense, even when they're already down a rack, and suddenly the item pickups just keep on accumulating, and a triple buyback. They know that this is just a hold that is going to be so incredibly difficult. They're just going to bring all these heroes back in. And losing a second lane of racks against the Naga team means, I mean, that's when the Envy shenanigans really start kicking him, where he can just sleep the heroes while his illusions take out that last lane of racks. So you don't want to go down four racks against the Naga Siren of Eternal Envy.
At the same time, they can also abuse you not having buyback. If Secret get that next pick, we've seen with the Zeus damage just basically explodes out of nowhere, and it may just be the game. See, and now Zeus gonna grab an Octarine as well, so the full combo is very much online now. The Veil, Octarine, Aether Lens for the Zeus, constant low cooldown song from the Naga to reset the fights, the Venge with incredible game-changing range on that swap.
Yeah, I accept it too now.
It's a screen. It's a screen range of swap.
Well, the illusion is what's really crazy about it.
Yeah.
The illusion means you get that second extra swap after you're dead. You still provide your team the aura as well. You get more follow-up stuns, so this makes life very difficult for VP. So you're not at all afraid of just swapping out a teammate and dying when you've got the axe. I mean, you're not afraid of doing it anyways in your five position bench, but it's even better when you've got the axe accepted, got that secondary life.
0.86, exciting new world. Maybe not for VP.
Yep.
This is something out of their nightmares, perhaps. More than their dreams. So really gain momentum. Not sure this is how they expected to get to the late game. Here they are, where their lineup was always hoping to be. We saw the early Darkseer Midas, and you said it right away, Gods. They want this to be a long one. Well, they're getting it.
Yeah, almost up to 800 GPM for the Naga, and Darkseer has easily kept up pace. VP, they are now the high ground defenders, a position their draft is not exactly bad at, but a position they just didn't want to be in based on what Secret picked up and what their lineup had going for them.
He's really got them pinned in the base here at build.
DK Phobos, the Ag Scepter, Nyx high ground defense is absolutely edible. It's a 7 second cooldown impel. That's one thing, I don't know how comfortable he was on the Nyx with the Ags. I think he's one of the best Nyx players out there, but I don't see him actually get the Ags all that often. Because like when they were pushing the bottom lane on the high ground, he was throwing the stun from like normal form, which I think maybe sometimes a mistake because the cooldown's much longer when you use it there, and also the range being a lot shorter. So I think you want to try and just go to like, if you're high ground pushing with Nyx, you just want to run forward, go like burrow yourself down and just start throwing spells, because even though you can't move while you're in the burrow, you're so impossible to kill because of the damage block. There you go. That's the range on an impale.
Just making sure it's working.
Yep.
Can confirm Phobos.
Trial runs.
It is. It's disgusting. They are. Ooh, I'm being put the high ground there.
It's annoying that the split push is really annoying for the Nyx, is the one big issue though.
Is this where we just see the song and then try to go for the side lanes? Envy? He's looking for it. Song comes through. He's going to send the illusion to the south. He's going to TP himself a bit to the north, but stays near the Radiant base. The illusions, all the while in the bottom lane, are doing some work to the tower, forcing out a pretty early glyph. Zero cost. And they're not going to leave. They're just going to continue to set up camp outside the base, wait for the song to cool down, and rinse and repeat. Phobos is getting frustrated with the whole predicament, has decided to leave the base as the Zeus ult comes out, looking to get vision set up here. Illusions will head towards the bottom lane. Ratting intensifies. There are the answers. Mid lane, it looks like they have found an opening. The Chrono comes out, but there's the swap for Puppy. Gets Weeha out of trouble. And even Puppy's too tanky to be killed off.
Turn to stone and pulled out.
Silent, trying to go on Misery. Can they kill anyone during this time? And all the while, Illusion's going to work in the bottom lane. They're actually getting more out of that Chronosphere than VP are. Secret just making VP look silly. Not sure what they can do. Oh, they do find the Naga. They do find the Naga. But can they kill the Naga is the real question here. Lil's desperately going to need to hit the study trench to set up with the Yules. Creeps continue to work slowly on the bottom lane. The back wall is there, though, turning the fight, perhaps keeping them alive. Now the swap. Lil pulled into the middle of the entire enemy team, but the Death Provenant, while it's going, Silence the one who's going to chop first here. It looks like Kaibox to the south. He does manage to survive. Still no heroes dead. G looking to rearm and re-engage. Second ultimate has been activated, but they're just ignoring him, trying to stay away for the entire duration of the fight. Pi, perhaps the first casualty. No, Puppy, again with the swaps. The saves, they just keep on coming. Maybe at long last we can kill a Stink and Venge and Spirit. Can we have that BPS? Yes, you can have our Venge, but the Venge is still going to continue the fight. Can't even get her out. Death Prophet dead with no buyback. Nyx dead with no buyback. Dazzle dead for a minute. BP on the run. Their last moments of this game, very likely. Chasing after Lil at long last. The Ultra Farm support. Lina 2 will fall. 4 are down, and BP have not managed to secure this game. Secret, rat it out, outplay them late. I feel pretty filthy at just having cast that. I can't imagine how they feel right now, gods.
That was some good old Naga Siren Dota. Secret played the high ground defense so incredibly well this game, and I mean, VP will be kicking themselves a bit. It was definitely not the result they were.